Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. This relatively recently described fossil from 334 million year old Scottish rocks shows traits typically associated with different groups of tetrapods. Many of these features were plesiomorphic, meaning that they resembled a primitive condition that was acquired when amphibians or four-limbed vertebrates first appeared. For instance, Eucrita's skull is similar to those of amphibians, resembling Balanerpeton, a contemporary tetrapod which is one of the earliest members of Temnospondyli, a group which may have led to modern amphibians. The palate, or roof of the mouth, is similar to those of reptiles, and the eye socket is Baphetid-like, with its closest relatives being Baphetids, such as Megalocephalus. It strongly suggests the idea that the separation of reptiles and living amphibians wasn't present when the early tetrapods arose. In other words, Eucrita's mosaic possession of characters seen in Baphetids, Anthracosaurs, or early Reptiliomorphs, and Temnospondyls indicates that these three groups diverged in the Carboniferous rather than earlier in the Devonian. The weird mix of traits makes determining Eucrita's phylogenetic position rather tricky. It inhabited a shallow lake surrounded by active volcanoes. Its limb proportions support terrestrial preferences, while skeletal features suggested it used buccal pumping, the type of breathing used by modern amphibians. Eucrita was a tiny predator that hunted insects. Eucrita means true creature, yet the discoverer of this creature had fun, because Eucrita melanolimnites, the type and only species, means creature from the Black Lagoon. It serves as a homage to the 1954 horror film Creature from the Black Lagoon. It was named by Jennifer A. Clock in 1998. Species include E. melanolimnites. It was an insectivore, up to 10 inches or 25 centimeters long, or a little less than a foot long. It has been discovered in Scotland, Europe. It lived during the Bichon of the Lower Carboniferous 345 to 330 million years ago. Fossil representation includes a partial skeleton. And with that, thank you for watching this program episode of Prehistoric Beasts. As a short, this is extremely short, fact-based episode. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.